Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this bag, and it uses our craft sacks that we sell in the holiday mini catalog. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, you're going to need two pieces of Early Espresso cardstock, and these are already punched out with a top note die. You're going to need one using the crumb cake cardstock. And we're going to be using the Sweet Snow Globe stamp. This is a single stamp that we sell. So we're going to ink this up. Today I'm going to be using the Timber Brown Stays On. I'm going to stamp it just like that. And then we're going to take your crumb cake ink. And you're going to stamp snowflakes using the Serene Snowflake stamp set. And I'm going to stamp off. And you could have done this first if you wanted to, but I didn't really want snowflakes under here, okay? And I think we're done with that one. Okay, you're going to take the 1 3/4 circle punch and punch that piece right out. So I'm going to clean the stamp. And then now I'm going to color this image using markers. I'm going to use the Early Espresso, Old Olive, and Riding Hood Red. And what I'm going to do is start with the dark color, or the Early Espresso. And then I'm just going to lightly brush across those snowflakes. And then down here at the bottom, you don't have to worry about the sides because that's not really going to show through. Okay, now I'm going to color the little tree with the Riding Hood Red. Not tree, the house. And then the trees are going to be Old Olive. And then don't forget to breathe on it, and then stamp it. Okay, now we're going to punch that piece out, and this is the actual piece that we're going to be using. Okay, so right now we need to color these in, color the little snowflakes in, so I'm going to use the little smoot, okay? And I'm just going to put a dot inside of every snowflake. Okay, and then I'm going to also color in the top of the trees and the roof on the house, the snow part. This works just like painting a finger, your fingernails, but easier. Okay, so we're going to let that dry for just a second. And we're going to go ahead and attach. What I've done is I've stamped this image again on another piece and I cut it out, okay? Because I want to pop this up. I think that looks really neat to pop it up. So I've put a dimensional on the back and I'm just going to line it up just like that. I did go ahead and stamp the greeting. So all I did was take the Wishing You a Merry Christmas from the Jolly Old Saint Nick set. And let me tell you the measurement of this. Although I have to tell you, you stamp it and then you cut it out really closely, and then I sponged it, okay? So it measures 1 3/4 by 11/16, okay? So let's go ahead and sponge this piece while that's still drying. We're going to use the Early Espresso ink. Oh, you know what? I'm doing the wrong thing. Back up. Rewind. Sorry about that. You don't want to sponge it just yet. You've got to cut this out, okay? Okay, so now I'm just going to take the little cutter kit and just rough that up even more so that it looks like what I've done here was intentional. Well, and it was. Okay, now we're going to sponge the edges. Okay, see how good that looks? Now I'm just going to sponge right around where this cup is going to go. Okay, so let's go ahead and assemble the bag, okay? I have taken the bag and cut it down to 3 inches, okay? So here it is. I'm going to go ahead and attach one piece. Now for this one, it's going to be a little bit trickier. What I'm going to do is use this, 2.5 inch punch. Because we're going to add a little bit of snow in here. Okay, so we need to put something behind here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is attach this piece to this circle. And then we're going to attach it just like that, okay? But first we've got to put snow in there. So I've got myself a little bowl of snow and iridescent ice embossing powder. And you know what? The snow, I'm just going to put just a little bit in there. Not much. In fact, that's probably good. And then just a little bit of glitter. Or embossing powder. I always call it glitter. And then what we'll do is just go ahead and peel this. Okay, so see how I've attached that? Now it fits just like that, okay? So I'm just going to tape this down using some Scotch tape. Making sure that I have it exactly where I want it. Okay, so now I'm going to put the adhesive on the top note to attach this. And see, by distressing it a bunch, it just kind of blends in with the espresso top note, I think. See? Okay, now we're just going to attach this. We're going to put a dimensional on the back. Or 2 dimensionals. And then we're going to attach it to the bag, and you're going to put your adhesive on the bag and not this piece. And then you're just going to line this up. And we have another step. Okay, now let me get the... Okay, so we're going to lay this here in the box. And we're going to spray it using the Champagne Mist Shimmer Paint with alcohol. This has just become my best friend. And when you spray it, I don't know if you've tried it or not at home yourself, but when you spray it, it darkens the cardstock a bit, which gives it an even richer look. I just love it. See? And then you would just add some crinkle paper. So we'll borrow some from this one. That kind of looked disastrous, didn't it? So there you have it. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks a lot. Bye.